This is Mac from jlptbootcamp.com here with another N5 grammar lesson. This time we're going to be looking at dare and nani, two question words. Dare is who, nani is what. And again, you're with your friend, you're speaking casually, and you're showing your friend some pictures. Your friend asks you about the person in the picture. He asks, kono hito wa dare? And you answer, tomodachi no jo da. So first, he's using casual. He's asking kono hito, this person. Maybe he's pointing at the picture. Wa is the topic marker, so to mark that we're talking about this person. And dare is who. Now, on the test, you would see this in polite form. It would be dare desu ka. But again, when you're speaking casually amongst your friends, you would just say dare. You wouldn't add anything extra. And to respond, you'd say tomodachi no. This is my friend. My friend name, you have to add that no there at the end. Tomodachi is the word for a friend in Japanese. And your friend's name is Joe. So tomodachi no Joe da. So my friend Joe. And your friend is using a very common structure in Japanese where you mark what you're asking about with the wa particle and then asking who. And again, the polite form would be dare desu ka. And wa would mark what you're asking about, the topic of the sentence. So for example, a little bit more complicated sentence would be, adoteru hito wa dare desu ka? Who is the person dancing? Maybe you can imagine you're at a party or something, you're looking at a big group of people, you want to ask about a particular person without pointing at them directly. You could use this structure. Now, you're looking at some more photos, and now your friend asks you, dare to hanashiteru no ka? And you respond, jiru da. So he's asking, who are you talking with in the picture? Dare to, to is particle that means with. Dare again is who, of course. Hanashiteru is the present progressive, basically ing, talking. You are talking. And no ka is how to form the question in this situation casually. Again, no is kind of has a feeling of I want to know about this situation. I'm asking about this. Ka is the question marking particle. And jiru da, you're answering the question. So that's Jill. Now, here's another structure here. Dare combining with the to particle. To means with, again. And this can be used to ask about, well, who are you with? What are you doing this action with? For example, another sentence, you would say, dare to isho ni kampu shimasu ka? Who are you camping with? This is a question about the future. Again, this is in polite form, which you'll see on the N5 exam. In the previous example, it's two friends talking, they're using the casual tense, but on the N5 exam, you'll see this mas form in this common kind of structure, dare to, some kind of action, and ka, the question marking particle. And we're gonna look at one more dare pattern. Your friend is looking at another picture. He asks, dare ga sono keiki o tsukutta no? And you respond, jiru da. So he asks, who made this cake? Dare ga, it's marking the subject, the person that's, we don't know, we want to know the person that's doing the action. Sono keiki, I know this is a lot of times translated as that cake, but it can also be translated as the cake in the picture. And tsukutta is the past tense of to make. No is a casual way to make a question. And this is the last pattern, and this is probably, this is a very common pattern. Of course, you want to know who did something. It's dare ga, some kind of action, plus ka. Another example in polite form would be dare ga zenbu osara o araimashita. Araimashita ka. So who washed all the dishes? And again, this is in polite form. You just add the ka to the end there. Just a sentence and add ka. And with dare, there's some kind of useful expressions that we can use that you'll see a lot of. These these common structures to that you can just add the mo particle and make nobody with negative verbs. So for example, sono keiki wa daremo tabemasen deshita. Nobody ate the cake. So if you're saying dare and you add the mo particle with negative verbs, this means nobody. With positive, it can sometimes mean somebody, but it's not usually used that way. Usually it's used as nobody. If you want to talk about somebody, you would add the ka, dare ka. So for example, dare ka ga sono keiki o tabemashita. Somebody ate the cake. Maybe your cake, you're angry that somebody ate your cake. And another example here, dare ka keiki o tsukurimashita ka. Now, you might notice that in these two examples for somebody, the first one uses the subject marking particle ga, and the second one doesn't. Now, for dare ka, you don't need a particle. If it's easily understood from the context, you don't need to use it. And this is something that might sneak up on you in the grammar section, because you might be looking for the ga subject marker and it's not there. It's because it's not needed. For nobody, daremo, you actually can't add any particles after it. You can't say daremo ga. That doesn't make any sense. So daremo is usually by itself. There's no extra particles. It gets a little bit more complicated. You can kind of change this around and add in some more particles, but at the N5 level, you're not going to see any particles after daremo. You'll learn about some other structures as you move up into more complicated grammar. Anyway, you're continuing on. Your friend is looking at some more pictures, and he looks at a new picture. He says, "Kore wa nani?" And you respond, tortilla da. So now you're looking at some Mexican food here. Your friend is asking, kore wa, this thing, thing that I'm pointing at, what is it? Nani is what? And you answer, it's a tortilla. And this is nani or nan. This means what, of course, and just like dare, it has this same sentence pattern, some kind of topic, wa nan desu ka, what is this thing? So this is very commonly used with kore wa, sore wa, but you can also use it a little bit more complicated ways. For example, this sentence, sono aoi no wa nan desu ka, what is this blue thing? Aoi is blue. No is a nominalizer and makes it a noun. Wa is the topic marker. So you're asking about this particular topic. What is it? What is this blue thing? You can use it a little bit more complicated ways like that. Now you might be wondering, in the first conversation, your friend used nani. In the second example, with the polite form, we use nan, nan desu ka. Nani and nan, they both mean what. And basically, the difference is with nan, you use it with the copula, which the copula is des or da. So for example, you'd say nan desu ka, you wouldn't say nani desu ka, or you would say nan da. Basically, there's a few other exceptions than this, but 95% of the time, this is where you'll see the difference. Nan is used with copula, nani is used with pretty much everything else. Nani ga, nani o. Any other kind of particle, nani de, you're using just nani. So, final question your friend has for you. He asks, nani o shiteru no? So, and you answer, takos o tsukuteru. So, nani o is what kind of object? O is the object marking particle. Shiteru no is what. Actually, shiteru is doing something. No is the casual way to mark a sentence. Tacos, oh, of course, is tacos, Mexican tacos. It's always, in Japanese, it's always tacos. So, because taco in Japanese, of course, means octopus. So, when you want to talk about tacos, you always have to add that S, tacos. Otherwise, people in Japan might not understand what you're talking about. So tacos o is marking the object, the tacos, and tsukuteru is you're making something, the ing again. So this pattern, it's very much like the dare pattern. It's nani o, some kind of action, ka. So what you're doing some kind of action to an object. So for example, nani o motte imasu ka. So what are you carrying? Now, nani can be combined with other things like nani de, how are you doing something, nani ga, of course, nani ga, nani o, to change how it's used in the particular sentence. So let's go over a quick pop quiz before we run out of time here. Some quick translation. Can you translate this sentence? Who are you singing with? Now, to sing in Japanese is utau. So how would you say that in Japanese? And the answer would be, dare to utatte imasu ka? So who are you singing with? Another one, who is she? Again, a hint here, she is kanojo in Japanese. Answer would be, kanojo wa dare desu ka? And another one, what is this big thing? What is this big thing? Sono oki no wa nan desu ka? Sono is this or that or the. It's translated a couple different ways. No, it nominalizes it, makes it a thing. So oki is big, big thing. Wa is the topic marker, and nan desu ka is what. And two more here. Who bought the beer? Who bought the beer? What is that in Japanese? The answer would be, dare ga biru o kaimashita ka? Who bought the beer? So, dare ga is the subject. You want to know the subject of the sentence. Biru is beer, and kaimashita is the past tense of buy. Ka is the question marking particle. Last one, what are you eating? Answer would be, nani o tabete imasu ka? So nani o, you're asking about the object of the sentence. Tabete imasu is the ing form. You change the verb into the te form, you add imasu, that's the ing. What are you doing? What are you eating? And ka is the question marking particle. So real quick review. With dare, you can use some kind of topic plus wa plus dare desu ka. Who is this person? Dare to, action plus ka is who are you doing this with? Dare ga is who did this action. And with dare, you can make nobody with dare mo, somebody with dare ka, and you don't need to use a particle with dare ka. You can to make it clear, but you don't have to. And finally, you have nani and nan. They're used topic wa, some kind of topic you want to know. What is this thing, object? And nani o, action ka. So what is the object that you are doing something with? So that's it for nani and dare. If you know someone that is studying for the N5 exam or is just starting out in Japanese, they will probably find this video very helpful. Do them a favor and send it on to them so you can spread the knowledge. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. I hope to hear from you soon. This has been a grammar explanation video from the JLPT Bootcamp premium site. Inside the site, you will find some extra goodies, for example, some cheat sheets for all of the videos. And those cheat sheets include a few things, for example, some common mistakes that people make, as well as some example test questions for the JLPT. If you're interested in taking the JLPT and you want that extra edge, something to kind of push you above and get the points that you need to pass, I encourage you to stop by the website at jlptbootcamp.com/premium. There you can find the cheat sheets as well as some extra practice with the grammar points that I've been talking about today. Hope to see you in the premium site very soon. This has been Mac from jlptbootcamp.com.